Parliament is scheduled to resume plenary sittings tomorrow, Wednesday. Notable on the day's agenda is the last reading and a possible vote to pass the contentious Coffee Amendment Bill 2024. Today, the members of Parliament on the opposition side, led by Joel Senyonyi, reaffirmed their commitment to block the passing of the controversial bill.
And colleagues have given me assurance they will be here tomorrow early enough so that we defend the people of Uganda. And as we do this, we'd like to call upon the people of Uganda, let's join this fight. Because it is your coffee, it is my coffee, it is our coffee, all of us.
The last sitting was adjourned dramatically when members of parliament opposed to the bill, mainly from the opposition side, put up a strong resistance against a vote to decide on the matter.
The issue of coffee is an issue of Uganda, not Buganda. So all those who are trying to divide the people of Uganda to make it seem like it is them against you, no, this is for all of us.
Item number 5 on the order paper in tomorrow's plenary sitting is the third reading of the National Coffee Amendment Bill 2024 to be presented by the Minister of Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries, Frank Tumwebaze. President Museveni, the government chief whip Dennis Samson Obua, Agriculture Minister Frank Tumwebaze, and the Minister of ICT and National Guidance Chris Bariomunsi have stated in chorus that mainstreaming the UCDA is part of the general rationalization process which started in February 2021. The rationalization of government agencies is aimed at ceasing duplication of functions and overlaps, wasteful expenditure, and realigning service delivery. The court this morning was set to hear evidence from the 10th prosecution witness into the murder of Henry Katanga. After a two-week adjournment, the prosecution was expected to resume its narrative on the details surrounding the death of Katanga. However, the state attorney, Jonathan Muwanganya, informed the court presided over by Judge Isaac Muwata that their undisclosed witness arrived late in Kampala and was unable to proceed after failing to access the exhibit store. He therefore asked the court to grant his prayer that the case be deferred to Wednesday. Judge Mawata was forced to adjourn the hearing to tomorrow, Wednesday. The defense lawyers led by Peter Kabasi and Mark Dosman Kabega were left with no option but to concede to the request of the state.
Preliminary reports said to have been forwarded to the DPP. The member of the DPP construct a charge sheet of indictment before the reports came out. I've not been surprised.
On November 2, 2023, Mr. Katanga was found dead at his home in Chua 2 Road in Mbuya, near Kampala, following what is believed to be a domestic brawl with his wife, Molly Katanga. Molly is jointly charged with her two daughters, Patricia Kakwanza and Martha Nkwanzi, who faced lesser charges of destroying evidence and being accessories after the fact of murder. Voters in the U.S. hamlet of Dixville Notch launched Election Day in the first minutes of Tuesday with a tight vote mirroring the incredibly close national polls in the White House race. Kamala Harris and Donald Trump each got 3 ballots in the tiny community in the northeastern state of New Hampshire, which for decades has kicked off Election Day at the stroke of midnight, hours before the rest of the country's polling stations open.
Machinery involved, there's no lobbying that's going on, there's no door knocking, there's 6 people who get together election eve for the purpose of voting.
Kamala Harris and Donald Trump made the final case Monday in the hours before Election Day, when voters will either choose America's first woman president or hand the Republican an unprecedented comeback likely to rattle the world. With polls showing a dead heat, Trump promised to lead the United States to a new heights of glory, while Harris said the momentum is on our side as the rivals held the last rallies of the 2024 race in crucial battleground states.